Hey guys, this is Brad Lincoln with a COVID update. Now this is an update as of the 7th of September, 2021. It's been a while since I did one of these. Nick took over and took the reins on the last one because I was a bit sick, did not have COVID. Let me stress, I did not have COVID, but did lose my voice for a period, so it would have made it quite difficult to do a video. But I want to give you guys some updates as I understand from what I'm hearing from the guys in our UK office and the Philippines office. There's been some pretty bad publicity about what's going on in Australia at the moment. And I just want to reassure you that, I mean, as you guys are aware, the media beats up a lot, okay? It's nowhere near as bad as what it's getting made out to be. So let's just have a look and go through some stats and some of the things that are happening here currently in Australia. And I want to show you the good things that are happening, the things that are allowing us to move forward and making it closer and closer for you guys to get out here. So first thing we're going to look at is vaccination rates. Okay, the vaccination rates did start off a little slow due to sort of issues getting them into the country and just physically delivering them and how they were going to do it and implementing that plan. But that has really, really kicked off now. And so to give you an idea, they've delivered over 20.8 million doses of vaccine so far, with 7.8 million people classified as fully vaccinated, which works out to be about 38% of the entire population vaccinated. Nick mentioned in the previous video, I just want to touch on this again, the 80% population vaccination number. Now this is the golden number we need to hit, guys. The moment we hit this 80%, basically the government has said Australia is reopening. Simple as that. They can't sustain being this little fortress at the bottom of the world anymore. So at 80% where we're going to be reopened, people will be able to arrive and get back out here. Now with that 80% number, as I said, at the moment we're sitting at about 38%. If the numbers keep going the way they are at the moment, we should hit that 80% by around October, end of October, start of November. That's what everyone's aiming for. And you'll see by a couple of the other big announcements that I've got coming up for you that all the companies, all the industries, the governments are all planning for it around this time. Okay, so we are getting very, very close and we will obviously keep you updated on any changes that sort of might happen or any issues, but everything's looking really good for that end of October timeframe. Another really big announcement is international flights to resume by Christmas. Okay, so this is some really big news. Qantas and Virgin, Australia's two biggest airlines, have both confirmed that they want to have international flights running from December this year. This has been the best indication yet that everything is on track for people to start entering by December. And it was what we've said pretty much from the start. By January 2022, everything should be back to some form of normality. And people are entering, they're coming in for semester one intakes for their studies or for their travel or whatever it is that they want to do. Okay, so things are looking really, really good for the flights. Another thing they've mentioned is the green zones. Okay, so the green zones, we haven't got an official list yet of what the green zones are. So this is where the countries most likely you remember enter Australia quite freely with no issues. A green zone is going to be classed off how much of the population in that country is vaccinated, which is pretty important. Obviously Australia's been pretty scrupulous with getting the vaccinations done and all that sort of stuff. So they just want to be working with countries who have got that same mindset and having people who are coming here who are fully vaccinated. Now, as I said, we haven't got any official list yet of what the green zones are or where they'll be. But what we have got is the list of Qantas's first flight routes and routes, you know what I mean, that are going to be where they're flying to first and going to be bringing people back from. So let me go through this list for you. It's pretty exciting. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people jumping out of their skin when they hear these names. But first up, we got Singapore, which I don't think there was really too much of a surprise there. United States, Japan, Canada, Fiji and the Pacific Islands, and the United Kingdom. Obviously, these are subject to change. There's been no official list released yet. This is just where Qantas has made plans to do their first routes from. But I believe, if Qantas is planning to go to these destinations, they work very, very closely with government. I would assume they have some form of inside knowledge that these are the destinations that they're going to allow travel from, because why would you be flying to somewhere that you're not allowed to bring anyone back from? You know what I mean? It doesn't really make sense. So I think this is a very strong indication of the first countries that are going to be able to enter Australia. So some very good news for the guys from Singapore, US, Japan, Canada, Fiji, and the UK. Another big change that's been announced recently, there hasn't been too much information on this one, but the government is looking at different options apart from the 14-day mandatory hotel quarantine for people who are fully vaccinated. Obviously, if we're starting to bring big numbers in, the whole hotel quarantine thing not only adds a huge amount of cost to anyone looking to come to Australia, but it just diminishes the resources of hotels, security staff, police force. I mean, all these are monitored by many, many different people, and it has a huge impact on the local governments and local economies and things like that. So for people who are fully vaccinated, they are looking at a lot of different options, home quarantine being one, depending on where you're coming from, depending if you've had a recent negative test, whether quarantine's even gonna be necessary. As I said, there hasn't been a huge amount of information about this at this stage. We'll definitely keep you updated on this. But I think that whole quarantine thing, as it has been a bit of a worry to a lot of people wanting to come to Australia, is gonna be slowly phased out into sort of other areas or other options. Again, it's gonna be depending on your vaccination rates, whether or not you're vaccinated personally, and negative test history and things like that. So we'll keep you up to date on that one. And finally, guys, enrollment updates for the schools. Now, obviously we're getting very, very close to January. A few spots left in some of the January courses, but July 2022, we are seeing a huge uptake of enrollments. Obviously people have been following this news very closely, expect the government to be open and Australia to be fully open by January 2022. So there are a huge amount of people who are making the plans for entering in July and earlier for that semester two intake. The uptake of enrollments we've had has been phenomenal, as they have been really throughout this period. It's been really encouraging. Obviously a business who's built on bringing people out to Australia, and when borders are closed, it does make it quite difficult. But we've still had so much interest, so many people going through the process and getting their enrollments done. So the moment those borders open, as I've said to you, preparation is key. The moment those borders open, they're gonna be able to enter. So if that's something you're wanting to do and you're looking at getting out here in 2022, without sounding like a broken record, guys, get in contact. Let us get this process started for you so you have an absolutely smooth transition into getting out to Australia, undertaking your studies and moving forward with that sort of goal of studying in Australia. So guys, that about wraps it up for the COVID update for September 2021. I hope you have seen some of the positive elements that have come out of this update compared to some of the bad stuff you're hearing in the media around the world. But things are looking good, and it's, as I said, it's really encouraging to see all the contact we get, the positive feedback we get about providing you with these videos and these updates, giving you a real insight on what's going on here. It has made this whole process a lot more rewarding, so to speak. And hopefully these COVID updates, we're not gonna have to do too many more of them, because things will relax and things will be back to normal, and you'll just have me and Nick sitting here talking about your different courses and your different migration options instead of COVID this and COVID that. So fingers crossed, guys, this is one of the last videos we're gonna be doing on this, and I very much look forward to hearing from you soon. And as always, if you do have any questions or wanna undertake studying in Australia, never hesitate to contact the team at Pathway to Oz. Thanks.